Now you're able to see my presentation. You can hear me, right?
Yes, everything is great.
Okay, thank you. So my name is Alexander Kichigin, and our work is devoted to simulate electron energy loss spectroscopy and cathodoluminescence in the discrete dipole approximation. Cathodoluminescence and ELISS are experimental techniques performed in an electron microscope. When fast electrons interact with a particle, they lose energy, and measuring their final energy and knowing their initial energy in the experiment, ELISS spectrum can be calculated by the difference in those energies. The particle, when interacting with fast electrons, excites and starts emitting light. This light is also collected, its intensity is measured, and this is how cathodoluminescence spectrum is obtained. We use the discrete dipole approximation in our work to simulate both ELISS and cathodoluminescence. And when we started our work, we found that there's only a theory to simulate those processes for particles that are in vacuum. But the particles are never in vacuum because there's always a particle, an electron, and the substrate that holds the particle. So we wanted to concentrate on the case of particles embedded inside the substrate. And we derived the theory to simulate the ELISS and CL probability for particles embedded inside any host medium, including Cherenkov radiation case or even absorbing host medium. We implemented this new theory in open source software ADDE and compared the simulation results to the Lorentz-Smith theory for spheres, got perfect agreement, and made a simulation for a couple of experiments, one of which is here. It is made for a gold nanorod, which is placed inside glass substrate. The experiment is done in 2018. Here's the ELISS spectrum for this gold nanorod averaged over its cross section, and the simulated spectrum is here. We can see the agreement between the experimental peaks and the simulated peaks. And these are plasmon maps for four plasmon peaks distinguished in experiment and distinguished in the simulation. Plasmon map is basically a map, a probability density map, which answers to the question, which to for an electron to lose the resonance energy, at which position on the cross section of the nanoparticle you should shoot electrons so that they lose this amount of energy. And we can see that the plasmon maps for simulations and experiment are in agreement. I want to also mention that, as some of you who use ADDE know, that ADDE is a console tool which does not produce images by itself. So we made a Python library to automate the simulations and automatically generate both the spectrum images and the plasmon maps images. So those images are generated by Python library with no additional work from tools like Origin or something you may use to generate spectra or plasmon maps from the raw data. So in this work, we already derived theory for ELISS and cathodoluminescence for particles embedded in substrate. We implemented it in open source software ADDE. And we got the agreement to the Lorentz-Smith theory and to the experiment. And our future work is devoted to the same ELISS and CL spectra for particles near a substrate. The theories that we derived right now are in beta stage at this fork on GitHub. And there are already two examples to simulate both the spheres, ELISS and CL spectra, and the nanorod ELISS spectra. So it's in beta stage and is available for everyone from March, I believe. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Alexander. Are there any questions to the speaker? Okay, I don't see any hands, so maybe I have a short question. How do you model this electron exciting the field? Is it in the frequency domain? Because yes, the DDA is in the frequency domain.
Yes, at the works on frequency domain, I believe I didn't have time to show any theoretical equations and something like that. But the field of an electron is in frequency domain. We derived it using the Green's tensor for arbitrary host medium from the start. And the quantities that we calculate, basically the energy lost by an electron due to the interaction with the particle, are all in frequency domain as at the uses by design.
Okay, thank you very much. So let's go further. And the next speaker is Shangyu Zhang.